Yo, what is going on everybody? Shri Kanase here. So how to choose the right bids every single time for your Google shopping campaigns. Guys, let's face it, without the right bids, it is very hard for you to achieve any kind of sustainable results with Google Ads. Now, I know what you're probably thinking. You're thinking that since every time that product is literally one of the most important things you can have on your e-commerce store, and if you don't have the right products, it doesn't matter what kind of bid you set, it doesn't matter what kind of campaign you run, you're just not gonna get results, period. And that is definitely true. However, if you don't choose the right bids or even the bidding strategy for that matter, then it is going to be very hard for you to get the right kind of traffic for that product. So in this video, we're gonna cover how to choose the right bids so you can get results like the ones you're seeing on my screen. But let's just get right into it. First thing you'll have to do in order to find any type of success, however, is to destroy the like button down below until it turns blue. I promise, not gonna take more than 2 quick seconds. Okay, hopefully you have destroyed the like button down below. But how to choose the right bids and how to get results just like these ones. We're gonna come back to my Google Ads dashboard very shortly, but let's start talking about the general criteria of choosing the right bids. And of course, in order to kind of start talking about this, we're gonna start off by talking about my favorite, the general testing campaign. Because if you are following me for a while, you know that I love general testing campaigns. I talk about general testing campaigns a lot in my Google Ads Mastery course as well. The link will be in the description below for my Google Ads Mastery course. I have a lot of in-depth videos on shopping campaigns, bidding strategies, and so forth within that. So I'm not really gonna go into details about that in this video. But generally, general testing campaigns are made to test different products. That's basically what their main purpose is. So if you don't have the right bid for general testing campaigns, that kind of means you're not really giving your products the right chance to fully get tested properly and to fully be shown to the right audience. Because yes, if you don't have the right bid, you can be shown to the wrong audience. How? We'll cover that very shortly. But bidding can be based on 3 different things within a general testing campaign. Number one thing, profit margins. If you decide to kind of separate out your general testing campaign, maybe have different general testing campaigns even, then I recommend that you kind of divide it by the profit margins. But if you do that, then here's what you want to do. Let's say you want to have 3 different general testing campaigns, or within one general testing campaign, you want to have 3 different ad groups. Here's how you should do the bidding. For higher margin products, and I mean $75, $100, $200, $500, above that, you want to have bids of around 50 cents to 60 cents. Now, you may be thinking that if your profit margin is $1,000, then 50 cents to 60 cent bid is too low. And of course, that may be the case or that may not be the case. I've had a lot of products worth over $1,000 have average cost per link clicks of 40 cents or even 30 cents. So bids are important, but if you have other things in place, then those kind of overlap with the bidding. However, generally, higher margins definitely mean a lot of higher bids simply because you can afford that for that product. So I generally like to stay around 50 cents to 60 cents for higher margin products. Of course, if it's $500, $1,000 or more, then I might even go up to 70 cents, 80 cents. But those are very, very rare cases. Usually I don't do that. I stay within these ranges approximately. But let's say you have medium margin products. That means $40, $30, around that range, even $50. That is what I would consider medium margins. You want to have the bid around 45 cents to 49 cents. Now, this squiggly line right here simply means approximately. That means it can be a little bit below that. It can be even above that. But generally, depending on margin specifically, you can have a bid between 45 cents, 49 cents. This is just my own experience, what I found most success with. And this bid has allowed me to test thoroughly while being profitable. In the end, profit is king. So if you're not really getting profits, then the bidding doesn't matter. But finally, low margins, 35 cents to 44 cents. You can even go down to 30 cents. I have had run products within single ad group campaigns at around 30 cents, 25 cents even, but it just depends on the profit margin. If it's a really, really low margin product, like on the base border of $20, even 15, then I would do 30 cents, 25 cents, and so forth. But if you're dividing again by profit margins, this is where you want to be sticking at. Let's say you don't want to do that. Let's say you want to divide by the niche. Let's say you have different campaigns based on the niche. If it's a competitive niche, you want to be bidding higher. Obviously, if you're selling a fidget spinner, or if you're within a 3D printer niche, you want to bid higher just because of the sheer fact that there's a lot of other competitors out there selling those same exact products. And by competitors, I'm generally talking about dropshippers. It doesn't have to be the big brands like Amazon, eBay. I've always kind of avoided that from the beginning simply because we cannot compete with them, so we just avoid looking at their pricing. But generally, if it's a very dropshipping intensive niche, then I would bid much higher. Let's say it's not a dropshipping intensive niche. It's a niche where there's not a lot of dropshippers at all, if any. Then that, for that matter, you would want to be bidding around 40 cents to 49 cents. Again, a lot of other things can be determining this if you're in a less competitive niche, but your products are very, very high margins, then of course you can go a little bit above that. But generally, this is what I like to stay within, simply because if it's a lower competitive niche, not a lot of dropshippers, and it's harder for them to come within your niche, then it becomes very easy to bid lower and get away with a lot of extra profit. But let's say you don't want to do that. Let's say you just want to divide by the device, because yes, this can work very, very well. In case you don't feel like dividing by profit margins or niches, just have one campaign where it's only running to the mobile devices and one campaign running for only tablets and the third and final campaign running for only computers. What you want to do is whatever the higher performing device is, you want to have a higher bid for that. So let's say mobile phones is giving you the largest amount of conversions profitably and at the highest ROAS, you want to bid about 5 cents to 10 cents higher than whatever the original bid is within the general testing campaign for that device. And whatever is not really performing, maybe bid around the same rate as it was before, or if it's just a brand new campaign, bid lower than your other devices. And this can work really, really well. But that is pretty much it for general testing campaigns. I've been testing around a lot with different bidding strategies when it comes to general testing campaigns. In fact, one thing I was trying out for the past few weeks is target ROAS for general testing campaigns. I'll be releasing all of the things which I test around with inside my Google Ads Mastery course, because that is a group of paid individuals. So it just makes sense to kind of provide direct insight into my store within that course. So if you want to stay up to date with that, just go ahead and get my course. The link will be in the description. But let's say you don't want to try general testing campaign bidding strategies because you already got that covered. What should you be doing for the next part, which is smart shopping campaigns? Because if you really aren't running smart shopping campaigns right now in 2021 and onwards, then what are you exactly doing? Because smart shopping campaigns literally is one of the easiest ways to get extra money, that too, on autopilot. So what should a smart shopping campaign be based on? Obviously, we cannot do bidding for smart shopping because that's just not one of the options. Instead, you want to be treating the bidding as the target ROAS with smart shopping, and it should be based on the product type. What do I mean by this exactly? By product type, I'm talking about whether the products within the smart shopping campaign are winning products or losing products. If they're winning products, you don't really want to have any kind of target ROAS percentage set for that. So when you're starting your new smart shopping campaign, it gives you the ability to check that box and create a target ROAS percentage. I do not check that box if the products are all winning products. However, let's say the products are losing products, you're just kind of giving them a second go inside the smart shopping campaign just because you think that they're going to start working. In that case, you want to have a target ROAS percentage up to 350%. Right now, when I'm recording this video in October of 2021, what I'm noticing is that smart shopping campaigns without a target ROAS or with a very, very low target ROAS, like 300%, 320%, and so forth, are performing the best. That is simply what is working right now. The higher you go with target ROAS percentage, the lower amount of traffic you're gonna get. And in that way, your conversions will be impacted as well, because smart shopping campaigns work on data. If it's not getting a certain amount of sales within a given time period, it's just not gonna perform at all. So just because you have 500% target ROAS percentage does not mean it's gonna get you that percentage. In fact, it might even get you zero sales in total just because it's not able to get any data to work off of. So that's why you want to kind of have a realistic bid when it comes to smart shopping campaigns. But that is pretty much it for smart shopping campaigns. The next thing I want to look at is single product ad group campaigns. Now, before we look at that specifically, I want to take you guys over to my Google Ads dashboard and look at some of the campaigns right here. So as of right now, some of the campaigns which are standalone campaigns are the following. I'm going to check them off right here so you guys know exactly how they're performing. And I'm going to do that really quick. So this one right here, this one, and that is pretty much it for my standalone campaigns for single products. Now, the other campaigns are for something called product ad group campaigns. I just recently released a video talking about what these product ad group campaigns are, how I'm testing them, and so forth. If you want more info on what they are exactly, you can check out that video also in my Google Ads Mastery course. But With single ad group campaigns, as you guys can see looking at the ROAS, their ROAS has been performing well, but not as well as it could be. And that is simply because of the different things I'm testing out within this ad account and different things I'm finding results with. So with single product ad group campaigns, what I'm personally doing is whatever my testing campaign bid was. So let's say I have a product within my general testing campaign, and we're gonna go back right here, for example, this product right here within this campaign, let's say the bid was around 63 cents. What I do is whatever the bid is within my general testing campaign, I create a brand new campaign. You can duplicate the original one and create a brand new campaign. For that brand new campaign, you can set the bid at around 1 cent higher than whatever the bid within the general testing campaign was. So right here, as you guys can see, my average CPC is 64 cents. It has been very, very profitable so far. But that is generally what I'm finding the best kind of success with. Just whatever the bid is within the general testing campaign, just increase it by 1 cent to 5 cents. So that 63 cent bid can go all the way up to 64 and up to 68 cents. So it just kind of depends on your profit margins. The campaign that I was just showing you guys right here, this is actually for a product which has a higher profit margin, which is why I'm able to bid a much higher and get a good amount of profits from this campaign. But that is not always the case. It's just gonna depend on a large variety of things. But now I'm gonna go ahead and choose now the other kind of campaign which I have running, the more successful ones. And these are the product ad group campaigns. Majority of them are at the top. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna look at that. So right here, what we're gonna do now is look at the product ad groups campaign section, which is the next one. Exactly what should you be bidding for the product ad group campaigns, meaning a large niche or collection of products within one campaign. What I'm doing is whatever my testing campaign bid is on average. So let's say I have 5 different products from the same niche within my general testing campaign. Only one of them is a winner, but I just want to create a brand new campaign just to test all 5 together. Then whatever the bid is, I'm going to add all of it up divided by the number of products I have. So in this case, let's say I have 5 products, whatever my average bid is after I add it up, I'm going to divide by 5, and I'm going to add 1 cent to 5 cents to that bid. So for instance, let's go right here. This campaign right here, what I want to do is I want to go inside to the products group section, and I want to show you guys the bid. So I'm currently targeting a product type. So this is a collection of 3 different products within this campaign, and for all of them the bid is 47 cents. The only reason why I'm bidding at 47 cents is because if we go inside my general testing campaign, and it is this one right here, go to the product section, we can see that this product at the top right here for this month, it got me 3 sales, but the average bid for that was 46 cents. So what I did is I created a brand new campaign, not just of this product, but the collection, whatever that collection was, and created that brand new campaign and just set the bid at 1 cent higher. As you guys can see so far, it has been performing really, really well with a ROAS of 10.35. $66 spent for 685 in sales. Absolutely amazing numbers. But that is entirely possible if you choose the right bid. Again, all the way up from 1 cent higher to 5 cent higher. This is depending on your profit margins. If your profit margins are lower, just keep it around the 1 cent area. If it's higher, keep it around the 5 cent area. But that is pretty much it for the biz. I'm keeping it very simple and straightforward, not going too crazy. But as I have kept mentioning, I cover all of these things and a lot more inside my Google Ads Mastery course. You can find the link for that course in the description below. But if you guys found any type of value in this video, destroy the like button and destroy that subscribe button, and I'll see you guys next time.